All right, welcome everyone. This is the June and most likely final meeting of the Senate Standing Committee on Housing Construction and Community Development. Senator Betty Little, and I'm joined today by Senator Espeoff. And I have the following voting sheets for today's meeting from Senators Bella, Bonasek, Boyle, Gallivan, Kruger, Penapinto, and Young. And some of them may appear at the meeting, but we do have a quorum and voting here. So we do have a nomination. We could do that first. All right, we are considering the nomination of Dominic Marinelli as a member of the State Fire Prevention and Building Code Council. It's been submitted by the governor's office. Any objections?
No.
No? All right, we will pass this around for signature to the committee members later today. All right, and our first bill today is Senate Bill 5228, sponsored by Senator LaValle.
An act to amend the real property actions and proceedings law in relation to the purchase of the premises and a mortgage foreclosure sale by a group.
Are there any objections?
Move.
All right, opposed? Bill is moved. Senate Bill 5469 by Senator Felder.
An act to amend the multiple dwelling law in relation to the floor area ratio, FAR, in the city of New York.
Any objections?
Can I get an explanation, please?
Yes.
So this bill would allow the City of New York, through its zoning amendment procedure as specified in its city charter and subject to an environmental review, to establish appropriate densities for the development of new or enlarged residential multiple dwellings in New York City.
So it would provide the possibility for our development to be bigger, larger, and better.
Presumably.
Bigger, yeah. Better, by.
The ratio of the total building floor to the zoning lot. So we have these things even in local governments and rural areas.
And so what's the process now? Why?
So as you know, the FAR is the principal bulk regulation that controls the size of buildings in New York City. So it's the ratio of the total building floor area to the area of its zoning lots. Each zoning district in New York City has an FAR at which they have to adhere to. And then they multiply that by the area of the zoning lot, which produces this formula called the floor area ratio. So this bill essentially allows the City of New York to work through the zoning amendment procedures that already exist, and that they're already empowered to do so through their city charter. They would still have to go through an environmental review, and it allows them to establish what they believe is appropriate densities for the development of new or enlarged residential dwellings in New York City.
You know, many neighborhoods in the city of New York are concerned about overdevelopment and the density of the development in neighborhoods that have their own character, if you may, personality. And so I will be voting in the name.
Thank you, Senator.
Thank you. The bill is passed. And Senate Bill 6054A, sponsored by Senator Carlucci.
An act to amend the public housing law in relation to income from employment of children.
Any objections to the bill? Senator Boyle, welcome.
Thank you.
All right, the bill is passed. Senate Bill 7413, which will be referred to finance, and it's sponsored by me.
An act to amend the private housing finance law and the public authorities law in relation to providing an increase in bond and note authorization.
Any objections? Let's do a sign then. Thank you. The bill is passed. And Senate Bill 7669 by Senator O'Meara.
An act to amend the executive law in relation to standards for inspections of parking structures.
Move the bill.
The bill is passed. Senate Bill 7746 by Senator Carlucci.
An act to amend the executive law in relation to establishing a process for the revocation of a code enforcement officer's certificate.
Any objections? Okay, thank you. And the bill is passed. Senate Bill 7826 by Senator Carlucci.
An act to amend the executive law in relation to the adoption by local governments of higher or more restrictive standards for construction.
Move the bill.
Thank you, and the bill is passed. and Senate Bill 7827, also by me.
An act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to the membership of the New York State Housing Finance Agency, the Housing Trust Fund Corporation, and the Affordable Housing Corporation.
Can I get a brief explanation?
Sure, Senator. Currently, the Housing Trust Fund Corporation and the Affordable Housing Corporation exist as subsidiaries of HFA, the Housing Finance Agency. So this is essentially a transparency bill. So under current law, the Housing Finance Agency has a membership that consists of the Commissioner of DHCR, the Director of Budget, the Commissioner of Tax and Finance, and four members that are appointed by the Governor with the advice and consent of the Senate. Now the Housing Trust Fund Corporation, which is a subsidiary, has a different composition for its board. So that board consists of the Commissioner of DHCR, the Chair of HFA, and then one additional member that's appointed by the Chair of the Housing Trust Fund Corporation. AHC, again, a different subsidiary corporation, it consists of the Chair of HFA and then members that are to be constituted from time to time. So this basically streamlines all three of those boards to mirror what the larger overall corporation would be, the Housing Finance Agency, and it keeps the existing composition, but it adds a Senate appointee and an Assembly appointee to that process.
No minority appointees?
That's not how it's written, but, you know, it's up to the Senator if she wants to consider that.
Well, for that reason, I will be voting without rec. I would like to see for both houses a minority appointee.
Thank you. Yeah, we'll take that into consideration, certainly. Thank you. Senate Bill 7847A by Senator O'Meara.
An act to amend the real property tax law in relation to an exemption of capital improvements to multiple dwellings within certain cities. We did. We missed 7820.
Oh, right. I didn't see my name.
So do you want to take the vote on
my own bill, so, right.
Do you want to take the vote on 7847 first? And
yeah, we'll do Senator O'Meara's bill as long as we have it read. Okay. Bill is moved and the bill is passed. Thank you. We'll go back to Senate Bill 7828, also by me.
An act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to residential emergency services to offer repairs to the elderly program.
It's really working on the restore program, putting codifying what's actually the process and what's in existence. Thank you. And that bill is passed. And that concludes the calendar.
Second page.
Yeah. Doesn't conclude the calendar. And I did read these, but I'm just looking at this other thing to make sure that you sign this before you leave.
Okay.
That was my
nomination
distraction. Second page, we are to Senator Golden's bill, Senate 7895.
An act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to increasing the bonding authority of the New York City Housing Development Corporation.
Move the bill.
Bill is moved. Thank you. And the bill is passed. And Senate Bill 7903 by me, which will be referred to finance.
An act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to establishing the New York State First Home Savings Program, which authorizes first-time home buyers to establish savings accounts to purchase a home, and to amend the tax law in relation to establishing a personal income tax deduction for deposits into such accounts.
This is modeled after the college savings account, the 529, and has, you know, restrictions on it so that we see that it's done correctly and all, but I think it would be a nice way to, you know, many of our millennials are, the trend is to rent, and many times it's because they have college loans and everything else, and to try to save money to purchase a home, which can end up being your greatest equity. So.
Absolutely. Well, on behalf of the thousands of Long Island parents who have their children living in their basements, I'm saying.
All right, and that does conclude the thing. We will have the nomination signed, and thank you for signing that.
Thank you.
And thank you very much.
Okay.